And that's why we are always saying that we as civil society organizations, the African Alliance for Women's Empowerment, all our organizations here are working on a strategy which I call it the Triad of Empowerment. On the three pillars of empowerment, the first pillar is how to build the personality of the women. This applies for Africa and any other place. How the women is educated, how she is trained, how we build her capacity to be able to lead an enterprise, to be able to take a decision, personality, to be self-confidence, to know how we really be part of the decision making. The second piece and the pillar is the policy and the procedure. What policies the government is putting, what infrastructure, what law are promoting women, what law are in favor of engendering all the processes. What is the government putting in order to put small and medium enterprises into action, in order to fight against FGM in Africa, in order to achieve access to property and land in Africa? What is the real promotion that the government is doing to lobby to have this policy in place? And the third P is the product. What product do we women have in order to offer it to the community? If I am a good leader, I have taken my decision, I am good educated, and the policy and the infrastructure know it is great, what do we have to offer? Why should we go to Dubai or China to bring products to Africa to sell it? We need to promote our own African products. How can we add value to the products of Africa? Even the service product, if I am having an accountant firm, whatever services I am doing, it has to be on good quality, it has to be competitive, it has to be actually value added. And that's why also real partnership could come in. How can Italy with us, how can civil society organization with us in civil society in Africa build the capacity of our women entrepreneurs, build the capacity of the African women on an equal basis? And I think this circle, which I summarized in it, the whole component of empowerment, which is starting from raising up in the family, because I always say that democracy starts at home. Discrimination between a girl and a boy will always let a girl depend on the other. So actually it has to be on an equal basis. No discrimination at home. Democracy starts at home. And all the fight was about democracy. So this hierarchical, patriarchal culture should be demolished starting at home. The second issue is education, capacity building, training, entrepreneurship, because entrepreneurship is actually the real economic growth, and it's the job creation, it's how we build the economy of our countries. And the sixth is access to financial resources. What resources can be done? That's why I always say that financial resources is part of the whole factor. And access to technology, we all see now that technology is a real changing of everything. Revolution everywhere in North Africa started with social media. Technology is a real driver for change. So we have to use technology in order to change our African continent and build the development through e-commerce, through e-marketing. What can we do to open the markets? Minister said about trade. What can we do together for trade? How can we open the markets here in Italy for our African women products? This is how we really build partnership. Technical assistance and support services. Number nine is advocacy. We are here to advocate for the Nobel Prize for Women of Africa because they deserve it. They are suffering. All the burden is on our shoulders. So how can our walking Africa would be on a strong feet, not on a weak feet? We have to have strong feet to be able to walk Africa, to be able to launch our African development. And number 10 is project development. We have to do projects targeted for economic empowerment of women and for the real development of Africa, based on the partners of development, the government, the civil society, and the private sector. And for this, I share with you one project we just launched in Egypt. It is a project for the economic empowerment of women and entrepreneurial promotion for African Business Development Center. It has a training facility where we can build the capacity of our women. It has a marketplace where we can do trade, and we can see an exhibition center, and this also could be virtual contact between us and Italy. How can we promote a portal with a product with African women? We have a business incubator where women can start their businesses, an ICT center where technology is being educated to the women how to use it for their favor. We have technical, financial, and legal service. And also we have an innovation center, because we women of Africa, when we have an idea, where should we go to implement this idea? We need to have a body which guards our ideas. our innovation. So this is how we advise our women to start their business, and this is through actually to promote the economic empowerment of women. We have 5 target groups: the startup of businesses, how women can start their business. We help her to write her business plan. We help her to put a budget, to know the market. Small and medium enterprise, and women owners of companies even for export, and this is also can be done in the trade. Yesterday in the European Parliament, they are saying they are doing a trade agreement to open market for the, how can we do for Africa? This could be included. How can we open market for our African women entrepreneur product to have a small percentage for us? And 2 target groups which are very special: the cross-border women traders in Africa and the women in conflict zones. And we will hear from Sudan how they are doing in conflict zones and other things. This is the training center, Hatshepsut training center. We call it Hatshepsut, the newly in Egypt. And these are women that we already with the workshop after the revolution to tell them what is their role, how they can build the economy of Egypt, how they can be part of the real growth of Egypt based on social justice and democracy. And actually, this is the incubator, the ICT center, where we train women for technology. And also, we did awareness sessions with the university girls to tell them how can they be part of the real economic growth. And we also did a project which linking simple technology for entrepreneurship in the rural areas of south of Egypt. You can see this is an agricultural product. This is dried tomato. And we helped the women actually to see how we can grow this dried tomato. You can see lots of opportunities for women from the rural areas to have it as a project with the end product which is exported to you here in Europe into your supermarket. So if you go and see dried tomato in the supermarket, it's growing in the south of Egypt, and we are civil society organization helping the women to have financial support and to be able to build that capacity. We talk to the community leaders, we talk to their families, their children, to be part of the economic growth. We also have a training program in Darfur where we met the women and we asked them, what do you want to start your stability? Stability and security is about economic growth. And the women told us we receive lots of training about peace culture, peace training, but what we do also is we need projects to empower ourselves. So we started a chicken farm, a small chicken farm in Darfur. One woman started it, and with a small number of chickens, now she is supplying 500 families in her community. She's a big business woman, and she is now proud that there is stability around her community with such a small project. This is the cross-border women in Ethiopia. I know Italy and all of you with the Horn of Africa is now giving a lot of hazard for all the world with the piracy in Somalia, with everything. Why are there piracy? Why is there, the people are desperate there, no hope? Because there is poverty. We need to empower the private sector of Africa. We need to empower the women, the men, everybody to achieve real sustainable development. This is in Zimbabwe with such lovely products of women that we need to have them. This is exporters of Ethiopia that export the flowers to Holland. So actually, this is another part of Namibia, showing you how real women of Africa are doing to achieve economic empowerment. This was last conference we did in Cairo, the African Congress for Women Entrepreneurs, with 200 women, real working women for development of Africa, coming together to see how we partner all of us together to have real peace and security. So our way for peace and security in Africa is economic growth based on social justice, democracy, rule of law, investment in our human resources, including women and youth, in partnership with international partners on equal basis. And to empower women economically, we need to promote social economy, enhance the role of women in the private sector, promote women entrepreneurship, and promote the role of inter-African trade. I am ending here to say why economic empowerment of women to achieve financial independence of our African continent. Why achieve financial independence? To have the power of choice and voice. Without financial independence, we have no voice. That's why Africa should be developed on the basis of having economic empowerment based on our initiative together and building partnership together. So thank you very much.